In this video, let's talk about how you can actually exclude URL parameters from showing up in your URL. First, we're going to go ahead and jump into Google Analytics, and I want to show you what we're trying to avoid here to help keep clean data. So we're going to go to site content, we're going to go to all pages. And in this case, when you come to your pages, you see there's a bunch of pages that have regular URLs here, and there's some that have these little question marks and parameters. And this can be a problem because you can see this little C conversion XL and then a parameter. But maybe there's a lot of people who are seeing C conversion XL. In fact, we know that there are. So if I just do C, let's just do this, C/conversion XL, so I can see all those pages together. You can see here that I've got these different pages that are actually being separated out. In this case, these two by these parameters. Now I can actually disable that from happening. I can keep that from happening by removing those parameters and then having analytics just combine these and showing them as basically two page views, or in this case, combining this with this for a total of 7 page views, which is what we're gonna do. So here I've got the subconfirmation equals 1. Subconfirmation is my actual parameter. So this is the parameter. I'm just gonna go ahead and copy that. And then we're gonna go into our admin screen. We're gonna go into the view settings this time under our particular view. Remember, the view settings are related to your view, so make sure you're in the right view. Then you go to exclude URL query parameters here, and we're just gonna paste it in, and that's it. Now, if I had other ones, I could do another parameter here, another here, just put commas in, and then they would automatically all be removed. So when they came into your Google Analytics pages, they would be stripped off those URLs and then all grouped together, so you can very quickly and easily figure out which pages actually people are seeing, using what the results of those pages are. I want to know how you were able to apply the information that you've learned in this video. Do me a quick favor and leave a comment below. And of course, if you love topics around Google Analytics, be sure to like and subscribe to this channel so that you can make sure you stay updated on all the notifications when they're available.